Abby the Avenger is back. In case you haven't noticed, I have been on like a full year hiatus, and I do have an explanation for that. But before I begin, I just want to thank my amazing friend and coworker Trey for buying this game for me. It was a game that I'd wanted to try for a little while, and it's gonna start again. Yeah, it was a game that I wanted to try for a little while. And I talked about doing a blind Let's Play of, but then I ended up watching a playthrough of it anyway. This isn't a blind playthrough, so I'm actually going to turn this down a little bit, just a moment, so that I can speak. so you get a little bit of the sound. So my hiatus was because my PC wasn't exactly cooperating with me when I would try to render videos or even play games or watch videos. It was getting to the point where it was getting old, it was having issues, and I have several episodes of Minecraft recorded from well over a year ago that I need to put up, and I promise I will get up. I just couldn't render them. The computer didn't like it when I did. So after my coworker purchased this game for me, I decided I better get a new PC so I can play it and I can record it for you guys so that you can see it. And I know a lot of people know about this game, and I have a few people I know who have mixed feelings about this game, but trust me, this is such a neat game and I'm really looking forward to playing it for myself. I got myself a new headset, in case you haven't noticed, you can hear me more clearly, and I also have gotten a game controller, which I have never actually used before, so I'm really not sure how to use. I've never used one of these. I have no idea what I'm doing. So, name the fallen human. So I'm going to get right on it and name the fallen human Abby, obviously. I think the analog sensitivity is set incorrectly. Oh my gosh. Okay, there we go. Done. Okay. Yes. So, I know how this game works, and in case anybody is wondering, yes, I am playing a pacifist route, so... I'm such a cutie pie. So, here we go. I'm really looking forward to this. I've also not had the opportunity to really think up voices for these characters, and I know people have a lot of headcanon voices for these characters. So.
Howdy! I'm Flowey. Flowey the flower. You're new to the underground, aren't ya? Golly, you must be so confused. Someone ought to teach you how things work around here. I guess little old me will have to do. Ready? Here we go!
Okay, I'm turning down just a little bit because I can't hear myself. His music, oh my gosh. Oh, do I have to click back in game? Okay, here we go.
See that heart? That is your soul. The very culmination of your being. Your soul starts off weak, but can grow strong if you gain a lot of LV. What's LV stand for? Why, love, of course. You want some love, don't you? Don't worry, I'll share some with you. Down here, love is shared through little white friendliness pellets. Are you ready? Move around. Get as many as you can.
Oh, I actually didn't mean to to dodge them.
Hey, buddy, you missed them. Let's try again, okay?
Okay, this time it's gonna hit me. Yeah, okay.
You idiot. In this world, it's kill or be killed. Why would anyone pass up an opportunity like this? Die!
Creepy little flower.
What a terrible creature torturing such a poor innocent youth. Do not be afraid, my child. I am Toriel, caretaker of the ruins. I pass through this place every day to see if anyone has fallen down. You are the first human to come here in a long time. Come, I will guide you.
microphone compared to the... Okay, I don't know if that did anything for recording, but it helped me a little bit.
Lead the way, Toriel.
I'm not liking the configuration that I've done.
The shadow of the ruins looms above, filling you with determination.
As I said, I'm doing pacifist, so... Oh, no. Okay, I didn't mean to say. Okay, I'm going to compliment him. Rocket didn't understand what you said, but was flattered anyway.
Thus far, my child. However, I have a difficult request to ask of you. I would like you to walk to the end of the room by yourself. Forgive me for this.
I love that music.
Child, do not worry. I did not leave you.
she's so cute. I love her. Until you almost defeat them, they might not want to battle you anymore. If a monster does not want to fight you, please use some mercy, human.
Ribbon.
Okay. So here. Yes. I want a piece of monster candy. Okay. I'm not gonna take any more. If you take more than one, it'll start like calling you a monster. How nasty you are for taking more than one piece. Playfully crinkly leaves fills you with determination. Meekly. So, I think that's what I thought. You can spare this one right away. I should probably act next time to get that idea. Alright, this place. Because his name isn't yellow now. And I got 2 gold. So I know a few things about this game. I know some of the things that I need to do and some of the secrets, so I'm going to try to do them. Hello, this is Toriel. For no reason in particular, which do you prefer? Cinnamon or butterscotch? Well, I like the borders, but I really prefer cinnamon. Oh, I see. Thank you very much. This is Toriel. You do not dislike butterscotch, do you? I know what your preference is, but would you turn your nose up if you found it on your plate? Right, right. I understand. Thank you for being patient, by the way. Click. Okay. 3 out of 4 gray rocks recommend you push them. Okay. So. Oh, okay. Hi, Limson. Okay, I'm gonna act this time. And I'm gonna console him. Halfway through your first word, Wimsum bursts into tears and runs away. Aww. Don't cry, Wimsum. Aww. Okay, so that. Is this supposed to make a noise? Okay, this is the fun part, and I don't know if I can remember, but there's like a pattern downstairs that I'm supposed to do. Whoa, hello. A pair of rockets hop toward you. Compliment the first frog. It's gonna be the same dialogue. Alright, here's gonna be the fun part. Oh no, oh no! I need you too. Yes, I got it. Okay, let's do better this time. I forgot what I was doing. I knew I was supposed to stay on the floor, but yes, this is the pattern. Okay. Let's try again. I really did. Whoa. Oh, that was the. Remember again. Okay. gosh, so many rattles. Mold small and mold small. Okay. I'm just going to go ahead and do this anyway, just because it's silly. That's a sexy wiggle. Oh no! Oh, it exploded! Oh no! I didn't know it exploded! Oh my gosh. Okay, yeah, I'm staying. Yes, okay. Now, you... and... Whoa there, partner! Who said you could push me around, So you're asking me to move over? Okay, just for you, pumpkin. You want me to move some more? Alrighty, how's this? That was the wrong direction. Okay, I think I got it. This rock. Was that helpful? Okay. Stop talking. You wanted me to stay there? You're giving me a real workout. You're killing me, Smalls. Okay. Knowing the mouse might one day leave its hole and get the cheese, it fills me with determination. Sale. All proceeds go to real spiders. I've got 10. Jeez, go ahead. Some spiders crawled down and gave me a donut, but this one costs 18. Okay, so I can't do that yet, so I'm actually going to try to work up enough money to get that. Did you miss it? Spider bake sale down and to the right. Come eat food made by spiders for spiders of spiders. Ribbit, ribbit, sigh. My friend never listens to me. Whenever I talk, they skip through my words by pressing X. That's right, pressing X. Well, at least you listen to me. I do keep doing that to be online. Ribbit, ribbit. What does F4 stand for? 4 for 1. yellow. Okay, I'm going to... Yeah, yeah. Luke's drew near. I believe you're supposed to pick on him. You rude little snipe. Okay, maybe you're wrong. You're not supposed to pick on him. Okay, don't pick on him. Finally, someone gets it. It's a different critter that you are supposed to pick on. Luke gnashes his teeth. Okay, I can actually spare him that. I loved this. This is just such an awesome game. I've heard so many mixed opinions on it just because... Ooh, Vegetoid. Because of the fact that you can spare, and people are saying, oh, that's not a new concept, but if you're watching this and you have that opinion of it, and you're giving us a chance through my play, please know that that's not why everyone's so excited about the fact that you can spare them. It literally has to do with the results of your choices. Eat your greens! Yeah! I almost had it. I just want to get enough for that spider bake sale downstairs. This one, this is different. I'm gonna go ahead and go through the hole because there's literally something to do in like every place down here. There's a Vegetoid here, which I can get. Oops. You can get help from this guy. So. Drops the green veggies, and that gives me health. Okay. It only gave me one health. There we go. Oh, hello, looks. Don't pick on. I get you, looks. I was picked on as a child. I'm with with you. Poor thing. Okay. Is hard, so I can equip that and have higher defense. Okay. Spider cider, I like that. I love it. Spider cider. Hello, Vegetoid. It's so easy to want to press OK on that. My greens want to give them to me. Yeah. I'm getting better at dodging. I say that now. Here. Was there something? Was there a Vegetoid down here? It's getting dark out. Yeah, there's a Vegetoid down here too. So, let's see if I can get at least one more health here. Sorry, I was closing the blinds. The Vegetoid came out of the earth. Oh, I did it again. Jeez, I'm so afraid I'm accidentally gonna fight. Took me a while when I was first watching a playthrough of this, and I was like, what am I doing here? But I figured it out eventually. The door down, the far door is not an exit. It simply marks rotation and perspective. So each time I walk through the door, this is the same room, but it's going to rotate. So the blue dial or switch is there. I want to call it a dial, but it's a switch. It just reminds me of a little doll sitting on the floor. Green one's here. Orange one's there. Okay. So, red. So it was blue. So, if you can read this, press the blue switch, which is not this guy. Hello, Lux. Can I see you? No. Finally, someone gets it. I'll scare you. I should be able to heal. Okay. So mellow when you spare them. If you can read this, press the green switch. I'm gonna get one per room. A pair of Vegetoids. Oh no. I don't know if I like this. I've got a really bad feeling about this. Oh no. No. Oh my gosh. I'm gonna mercy that one just because that will leave one attack. not going to get me. Okay. Oh, no. No, 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 no. Please stop bouncing. Please. Oh, my gosh. I don't want to use any of my items yet. Oh, yeah. Yes. All right. Oh, my goodness. That was kind of nerve-wracking. All right. So. I don't remember what's over here.
Ribbit, Ribbit, just between you and me, I saw Toriel come out of here just a little while ago. She was carrying some groceries. I didn't ask what they were for. We were all too intimidated to talk to her, Ribbit.
That took longer than I thought it would. How did you get here, my child? Are you hurt? There, there. I will heal you. I should not have left you alone for so long. It was irresponsible to try to surprise you like this. Well, I suppose I cannot hide it any longer. Come, small one. Okay. Do you smell that? Surprise! It is a butterscotch cinnamon pie. I thought we might celebrate your arrival. I want you to have a nice time living here, so I will hold off on snail pie for tonight. Here, I have another surprise for you.
Oh, she's so sweet.
This is it. Ah, I love it. A room of your own. I hope you like it. At home.
This is so cute. I don't interest you at all. I don't care about these toys. My hands, the phones are hurting my head. Oh. You found a slice of butterscotch cinnamon pie. An empty photo frame. It's really dusty. A box of kids' shoes and a disparity of sizes. Oh! I'm gonna turn the light on. No, I'm leaving, so I'm gonna turn the light off. I love the music. I'm telling you. It's Toriel's diary. Read the circled passage.
Yes.
You read the passage. Why did the skeleton want a friend? Because she was feeling bonely. The rest of the page is filled with jokes of similar caliber. Oh, Toriel. Just a regular old bucket of snails.
Why does she have a bucket of snails in her room?
Okay.
Scandalous! Toriel! It's Toriel's sock drawer! Aww.
She's got scandalous socks. It's an encyclopedia of subterranean plants. You open to the middle. Typha, a group of wetland flowering plants with brown oblong seed pods, known more commonly as water sausages. Water sausages. Okay, come on. Which is what's in the pot over there. It's flower seeds and broken crayons.
It's you! Sausage.
I would have said it was a cattail, but okay. These books are worn. They must have been read many times. Inside is an old calendar from the beginning of 21X. Okay. Trapped behind the barrier and fearful of further human attacks, we retreated. Far, far into the earth we walked until we reached the cavern's end. This was our new home, which we named Home.
as great as our king is, he is pretty lousy at names.
Why?
Up already, I see. I want you to know how glad I am to have someone here. There are so many old books I want to share. I want to show you my favorite bug hunting spot. I've also prepared a curriculum for your education. This may come as a surprise to you, but I have always wanted to be a teacher. Actually, perhaps that isn't very surprising. Still, I am glad to have you living here. Oh, did you want something? What is it? When can I go home? What? This is your home now. Would you like to hear about this book I'm reading? It is called 72 Uses for Snails. How about it? But I want to know how to exit the ruins. How about an exciting snail fact? Did you know that snails make terrible shoelaces? Interesting. I have to do something. Stay here.
Okay. Before I follow her, I'm just looking here. For some reason, there's a brand name chocolate bar in the fridge. Brand name. Toriel, why? Why? The size of the pie intimidates you too much for you to eat it. That is a big pie. It's as big as her head. The stovetop is very clean. Toriel must use fire magic instead. By the way, I know that this character can be any gender, but since I'm playing and I'm female, then I'm going to play and she's going to be a female. I did not say that right. My words did not come out of my mouth right. Okay, now I'm going to follow Toriel.
Precarious staircase.
You wish to know how to return home, do you not? Ahead of us lies the end of the ruins, a one-way exit to the rest of the underground. I am going to destroy it. No one will ever be able to leave again. Now be a good child and go upstairs. Every human that falls down here meets the same fate. I have seen it again and again. They come. They leave. They die. You naive child. If you leave the ruins, they, Asgore, will kill you. I am only protecting you. Do you understand? Go to your room. Do not try to stop me. This is your final warning. I don't want to have to. You want to leave so badly? You are just like the others. There is only one solution to this. Prove yourself. Prove to me you are strong enough to survive.
Toriel blocks the way. Let's talk. I couldn't think of kind of conversation topics.
Oh god!
Oh, I remember. I'm supposed to be showing mercy. you want to go home, but please go upstairs now. I promise I will take good care of you here. I know we do not have much, but we can have a good life here. Why are you making this so difficult? Please go upstairs. Pathetic, is it not? I cannot save even a single child. No, I understand. You would just be unhappy trapped down here. The ruins are very small once you get used to them. It would not be right for you to grow up in a place like this. My expectations, my loneliness, my fear. For you, my child, I will put them aside. If you truly wish to leave the ruins, I will not stop you. However, when you leave, please do not come back. I hope you understand.
Mario!
Goodbye, my child. Now, really quick, I think there is a secret. You know, not a lot of people just don't even try to go after her, but I believe you can follow her. I think she's like in front of the house or something. I could be wrong. But I am gonna see. But just didn't go far enough. But I don't feel like going all the way back, because I don't think you get any like really special information out of it. But we're exiting the ruins. Here we go. Long room again. And this little butt turd again.
Clever. Very clever. You think you're really smart, don't you? In this world, it's kill or be killed. So you were able to play by your own rules. You spared the life of a single person. I bet you feel really great. You didn't kill anybody this time. But what will you do if you meet a relentless killer? You'll die and you'll die and you'll die. Until you tire of trying. What will you do then? Will you kill out of frustration? Or will you give up entirely on this world? And let me inherit the power to control it. I am the prince of this world's future. Don't worry, my little monarch. My plan isn't regicide. This is so much more interesting.
Creepy. Okay. Undertale. Okay. So this is probably... by Toby Fox! This is probably a good place to stop for now. So I'm going to end the recording here. And I will see you in the next episode. If you like what you see, then subscribe and leave a comment. See ya!